So now we are going to discuss different kind of models associated with the library automation. Library automation, you know, aims to support workflows of a library in an integrated setup. It means different subsystems of a library like acquisition, cataloging, circulation, serials control, your OPAC, etc. need to be supported by ILS. Therefore, to understand library automation, we need to understand first the library workflows. In fact, an ILS or library management system automates the workflow of a library as a system. So most of the ILSs or library automation software are based on a model that it is called procedural model of library automation. The procedural model of library automation was first proposed by Dr. P.A. Thomas in an analytical study of library automation conducted by ASLIF in the mid-1970s. So, still date, most of the library automation software, whether it is in Indian origin or foreign origin, are based on the procedural model of library automation, which was developed by Dr. P.A. Thomas. Now, in this particular model, Dr. P.A. Thomas says that any library system has mainly two subsystems. One is the administrative subsystem, another is the operational subsystem. And you please remember, in the administrative subsystem, we need to take different kind of decision, we need to go for different kind of policy making. So administrative subsystem we cannot automate because a computer cannot take decision on behalf of a library. We need to go for the automation of the operational subsystem. But automation of operational subsystem will help to run administrative subsystem in a better way. Clear? Because operational subsystem, when you are automating it, it can generate lot of reports, lot of information, management information system in real time. So on the basis of that statistics, that information, that reports, you can take decision in the right time and in the right manner. Now, operational subsystem, again Dr. P.A. Thomas said that an operational subsystem of library of any type of size has mainly four subsystems under it. And these four subsystems actually perform 18 procedures. And under each and every procedure, there are six possible activities. And to perform these six possible activities, there are 15 basic tasks. So, in a nutshell, this model is very simple. It actually describes a library that a library has two basic systems, administrative, operational. At the operational level, it has again four different subsystems. Each of these four subsystems are based on 18 procedures. These 18 procedures are basically running through six possible activities. And six possible activities are actually based on 15 basic tasks. So the beauty of the model is that Dr. Thomas divided the whole library system into a mathematical set. One library system, two basic subsystems, four operational subsystems, 18 procedures, six activities and 15 tasks. So on the basis of this, structural model of a library as a system is helping to generate different kind of integrated library system. Now, if you look into the picture, you see this picture actually reflects the model proposed by Dr. P.A. Thomas. It says that library housekeeping operations are basically performed through four operational subsystems: acquisition subsystem, processing subsystem, use subsystem and maintenance subsystem. Under the acquisition subsystem, there is again, you see, select, order, receive, accession. These are the four procedures available under acquisition subsystem. Now, if you go by the processing subsection, there are four procedures again: classify, catalog, label, sell. If you come to the use subsystem, there are the procedures like locate, that means to find a book, lend, that means to issue a book, reserve, to hold a book, recall, to return a book, Intel library load and photocopy or different kind of retrographic services. In the maintenance subsystem, we have three procedures: bind, replace, and discard. So as a whole, you see in this particular picture, there are four operational subsystems and 18 procedures. Now, if you move to the next picture, it basically gives you an idea about the library as a system. And on the basis of this particular model, your library automation software is based on. So here at the system level, you see there is a library system. At the subsystem level, there are two subsystems, operational subsystem and administrative subsystem. I already told you, administrative subsystem cannot be automated, but it can be benefited through the automation of operational subsystem. At the operational subsystem level, there are again four subsystems. One is the acquisition, second is the processing, third is the use, fourth is the maintenance. At the acquisition level, we have procedures like select, order, receive, access. Then processing level, that means technical processing level, we have the procedures like classify, catalog, label, serve. At the use level, we have locate, finding, list, lent or issue, reserve, recall or return, interlibrary load and photocopy. And at the maintenance level, bind, replace, discard. Now all these 18 procedures you see can perform through 6 activities. That means initiate to commence a particular procedure, authorize to approve a particular procedure, activate to implement a procedure through appropriate action, record you to record what action has been taken, then report to notify staff or user about the action taken, and cancel to stop a procedure or undoing an action. It does not require or it is not mandatory that all six activities can be implemented for each and every procedure. It may or it may not be. But these are the six possible activities. You suppose selecting a book can include all these six activities or the first five activities if you are not canceling the order. So these are the six possible activities through which 18 procedures are basically performed by the library staff. Initiate is basically you are making an attempt to start. Authorized, in some cases the decision to carry out a certain procedure must be approved before any further action is taken. Activate, when a procedure is known to be necessary and in some cases approved, it is usually implemented by taking appropriate actions. The record, the function that states or records what action has been taken. Report, to notify library staff or user that an action has been taken. Now cancel, to stop a procedure, in particular the aspect of revoking or undoing an action. So these are the six possible activities. You know already that a particular library automation software is based on the procedural model. Procedural model is basically helping us to know the library as a system. But again, before implementing your library automation by following the steps we discussed, we need to be sure the standards it supported. Because you see, the standards are the most important factor in the field of library. What is this? Well, it's basically type and size independent. A small public library is also using ASCII-2, DDC and many other library standards, as well as our national library. So almost all libraries are following certain kind of standards. So whether your library is a small library or a very big library, it does not matter. Your library automation should support the standards required. And library professionals are generally interested in the library standards developed by their own national body. Like for India, we need to go through different kind of standards developed by Bureau of Indian Standards, that is the BIS. And library standards, at the same time, we need to take notice of different library standards developed by ISO, International Standard Organization, NISO of United States, that is NISO stands for National Information Standards Organization, BSI, British Standard Institute UK, and the library standard developed by the NISO definitely American national standards, but anyway, these NISO standards are basically determining the standard of library automation all over the world. So we need to take care of four level of standards. The standards developed by BIS, the standard developed by ISO, standard developed by British Standard Institutes, and most importantly, the standards that are developed by ANSI NISO. Now, some of the standards we need to follow are the ISO 27009 standard. That means your library automation software must be compatible with ISO 27009 for bibliographic data interoperability. Standards bibliographic format we need to support, that is the MARC 21, UNIMARC or CCL, and all these standards are compatible with ISO 27009. We need to check whether the library automation software is supporting Z39.50 protocol standard or not. Z39.50 standard helps us to collect cataloging data, validated MARC 21, UNIMARC data from different library server into our local server. So that means you are getting through Z39.50, you are getting validated MARC data without paying a single buck to anybody. So it will increase the efficiency of cataloging, and at the same time it will reduce the unit cost of cataloging in the country. Then I already told you Z39.50 standard is very important standard for the holding statesman. Apart from that, we need to support ADFAQ for different kind of online commerce, online order placement, online payment. Now a new set of standards are also coming forward. Those are MARC XML, that is the MARC 21 data in an XML structure. This is also developed by the Library of Congress. You can have this particular standard from the website loc.gov. And this is acting as the base standard for bibliographic data export-import in place of ISO 27009. So that means ISO 27009 is becoming obsolete very quickly. And in place of the ISO 27009, MARC XML is coming as an interoperability standard for bibliographic data, and we need to take care of it. Another new sets of standards are already in the development process, and these are also developed by the Library of Congress. One is the MODS. Metadata Object Description Standard. This is an XML markup for selected metadata form like MARC 21 bibliographic format. Then PREMIS is coming as a preservation metadata, a data dictionary and supporting XML schemas for code preservation metadata needed to support the long-term preservation of digital materials. Your library automation software must support this. In place of Z39.50, the next generation standards are coming, that is the SRU, Search and Retrieve URL, SRW, Search and Retrieve Web. So these are basically all also developed by Library of Congress as open standard in place of Z39.50. So you need to check whether your library automation software is supporting this or not. Then comes the OAIP image version 2.0, because you see the difference between the digital library and automated library systems are blurring each day. Nowadays, most of the library automation software have the capabilities to act as a digital library management system through a new module. They call it DMA, Digital Media Archiving Module. So it is very much important in view of the present need that each library automation software must be capable to serve OAIP image based records. That means the software must have to be compatible with the OAIP image version 2.0. So this is all about the topic of discussion. We started with the library automation from theory and practice. So first we have defined that what is library automation. Then we actually discussed why library automation is required for a library. Then we also discussed the steps associated with the library, the prerequisite, what we need at the system level and the software level. Then we also discussed that the model of library automation, the procedural model of library automation, which is actually acting as the base of the modern library system. Then at the standard level, what we need, that means what we need to follow, we already have discussed, and there we came to conclude that most of the library automation system, apart from supporting different old, you know, standards, need to support a modern array of standards like MEDS, MODS, SRE, SRW, ADFAT, etc.